What's up guys, welcome back to another episode of Redstone Engineering. This video is going to go over how to make a 3x3 redstone door. This design is a little bit more chunky than some of the other designs, but it operates a lot faster because something that I find really annoying when I've made these 3x3 doors in the past is that this middle block doesn't get out of your way, so you have to wait for it to get out of your way before you can go through the door. And sometimes you're trying to run through it and then you hit the lever and then you have to wait here and then go through. So this design goes much quicker, and it also allows you to close it on the inside as well. So with that, let's jump right in. All right, so to start off, identify where you want to have the door, because you're gonna need a decent amount of space. You need three blocks in between your walls. So these blocks right here signify where the front wall goes, and likewise, this is where the back wall goes. The gold blocks are the actual door itself. And you need three blocks in between these doors, and you'll need about five blocks on either side of the door, so down to there. I'm not going to give you the exact amount, though, because you can always rewire it a little bit differently if your specific situation is different. And now let's place the pistons. So we need three pistons facing down into this gold block here. So we have it like this, so that when they're extended, the gold blocks are where they are right now, because you need to be able to pull them up, so they need to be extended when it's closed. We do the same thing on the bottom, so we put pistons here, facing up. Then on this side, we make a piston facing into this middle section right here. We don't need to worry about these corners, because of course they're already done by the top and bottom. And then this side is a little bit more complicated, so we put slime blocks here, or you can use honey blocks if they're easier for you to get. And then we do a double piston extender here, so we need to do quite far out. So you do two sticky pistons, and then you have two blocks in between the slime blocks, so that when these are extended, again, it's where it is right now. And then when it pulls back, it pulls this middle part back by two blocks, thus getting the middle block out of the way. Next, we need to wire up the redstone to all of these pistons. So we'll start with these top ones, and what we'll do is we'll put repeaters here so that it works in Bedrock Edition, because if you're in Java Edition, you can go up here and put repeaters here like this, but this won't work in Bedrock Edition, but there's no reason why we can't just do it like this. And I'm going to delay these two side ones by one, or by two if you include the first one, and then I'm going to delay the middle one by four, right? So you have two, four, and two. This is so when we wire up everything, the middle four gold blocks here all go at the same time, and the corners go before those, just so it's more visually appealing. If you don't care, then you don't need to switch the delays. And then what we'll do is we'll bring a redstone signal down to this side, and this will become clear in a minute. And this block needs to be obsidian, because the slime blocks are to come back here, but this needs to not move with it. We'll put redstone here, 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 and then we'll need to bring it down here in a second. So what we'll do here is, again, so that works in Bedrock Edition, put a repeater here. This is the middle block like this is, so we need to do a delay of four. And then we hook this up. We need to bring this signal up to the top, and it doesn't really matter how you do this. I'm just going to do it right here. And then we hook it up to the bottom, which we can do through this middle section right here, conveniently enough. And again, what we're going to do is use repeaters. And I'm going to use repeaters on this bottom part just so that we can have this floor here a little bit more comfortably. So we do that. Again, we do a delay of two, four, and two. We take this signal, and then this part, we need to add a little bit of extra stuff. So basically what we need to do is we need to have two torches right here, and then we have two more torches under that, just so we can interact with it from this signal down here. And then what we do is we hook up repeaters to these, to one of these guys, not that one, but this one. Actually, I think it's backwards. This one. And we make this a delay of two. So the side one, the far one, is no delay. This one is two delay. And we hook it up like that. And now we should have all of these hooked up properly. We're going to need to hook up the lever in a way that doesn't make us have to signal extend one of the sides, which usually means we hook it up down here, like on this block, but that's not really a problem because the lever is gonna have to be on this side anyways. So let's do that now. The lever can go wherever you'd like. I'm gonna put it here so that we can see the door open and close when we flip the lever, but you can put it wherever you'd like. Just know that if you want to have another lever on the inside, and we'll do this once we have everything else wired up. If you want to have a lever on the inside as well, so you have two levers and they both open and close the door so that you can open it on the outside and close it on the inside using nothing but levers, you're going to need to add a little bit of space. So I wouldn't recommend putting your lever like here, for example. But if you only need to open it or close it from one side, then you can put it wherever you want. I want to have two levers, so I'm going to put it kind of far away from the wall. And what we'll do is we're going to wire it up like this. And we'll actually add the other lever right now. So we need to add this somewhere that we can grab the signal. I'm going to do this one on the wall because I want to see the door when I flip this lever on the outside, but on the inside, I don't really care. So I'm going to grab the signal here. And what we need to do, if you're familiar with some of the other doors that we've done on this channel, we're going to do an XOR gate because that's how we can make them act independently of each other so that it doesn't matter which one you're turning off or on. It'll open and close the door just the same way. So we'll do that. So we take these. I'm going to bring this down, actually. And let's actually bring it a little bit further away. I just don't want to get it cramped up. But again, you can always move this stuff if your specific base just has space requirements. Like if you have a basement or something, you can even put this on the other side if you want. Okay, let's make an XOR gate. So the XOR gate consists of doing this. Let's bring this over here so that we don't have issues. And let's bring this direction, actually. That was actually quite far. I don't need to go that far. Okay. So in order to make an XOR gate, you do something like this. So you have your two inputs like that. You make this four block pattern. You put a torch here, 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 and here. You put redstone here. You put a torch here. And then you put redstone here. You put opaque blocks there again. And then you put torches here. And then this is your output. So we're going to need to hook up this output to the circuitry that hooks up all of these pistons together. We're going to need to do it in a way that allows us to not have to add a repeater halfway through. Like, say if we hooked it up down here, then the signal's not going to reach all the way over to this side. And I don't want to have to add a repeater somewhere in here, because not only do we not have space for that, but also it'll make our timings that we did on these repeaters and the ones below not matter anymore, because half of it's going to be out of sync anyways. So what we can do is just hook this up into two different places. So one down here, and then another one we can hook up somewhere down here. So we can bring it below this, have it not hook up to the other signal. And then let's see. So we need to hook up to this signal, and we need to hook up to this signal. So we can just probably bring it up. Let's see, right here, and then use glass to get it up the rest of the way like that. Okay, so now it hooks up to that part and it hooks up to these parts. And actually this is unnecessary because it's already doing it on this side. Okay, and then we can actually signal strengthen it. We don't need the signal strengthen actually, but we can, and I think I will, and I'll do that probably right here so we can make it go in there, they go there, and then it goes up the other way. So now basically the signal is a signal strength of 15 here. And it should reach all the way over here. If it doesn't, we can make it better. So now when we enable it, everything should enable. And when we pull it back, the door should open. Because of the XOR gate that we did down here, just like this front lever opens and closes the door, you can go through and you can also use this lever and it should do the exact same thing. It's a little bit further away, so it's harder to see. But it should open and close it independently, so you can open and close the door on either side. And now you can just fill in all of the blocks that you'd like. The only requirement is that this slime block is kind of awkward. You can use glazed terracotta or you can use obsidian or something. And actually, it's not necessary to use anything like that. But because if you use a block that isn't that, it'll get pulled. It looks kind of ugly from the back. So I'll just demonstrate this real fast. This is what it looks like from the back if you use a block that gets pulled by the slime. It's a little bit less glamorous and it's kind of strange because it'll also just show you all this inner working stuff. But it's not actually a requirement that it doesn't get pulled because it works fully fine. So do what you want. I recommend you doing obsidian because then if you use a darker block like this, then it looks a little bit better. And then when you close it, it looks a lot better. Even though the slime blocks here are still kind of awkward, it's a little bit better than having a bunch of random blocks there. And there we have it. There is a fast-functioning 3x3 door that you can use for whatever you'd like. One that also has levers on either end, and one that is pretty visually appealing when we open and close the door. I hope you found this video useful, and I hope that you can follow along with the tutorial and not have any issues, but if there are issues, let me know in the comments and I'll be happy to answer them. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you next time.